This is from Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom of the Opera, the phantom that most people know.
The Phantom of the Opera is now.
But now there's another phantom, the original Phantom of the Opera, the Brilliant calls it, about to open in London. This one was first produced in Morecambe in 1976, came later in 1984 to Stratford East's Theatre Royal, went on tour to America in 1987, and this year returned to its homeland, where it's been on tour for the last 6 months.
Christine.
To pain my heart selfishly dooms me.
At one time, the producers of this Phantom and Andrew Lloyd Webber talked about working together on the show. But Lloyd Webber decided to do it his way and wrote the music for his Phantom, and the producers of this one did their thing, using music from well-known opera composers for their Phantom.
No, I will never control.
Director Ken Hill says he's never seen Lloyd Webber's Phantom, so he can't compare the two. So he went ahead anyway and did just that.
Andrew's, of course, is as you would expect, but he had no choice, really. I mean, here he is, an international composer of enormous renown, producing a major show in the West End, and has to have all those huge set-piece, spectacular pieces that are sort of almost required, if you like. We don't go in for that. Our show is... How should I describe it? I don't want to say small, because that makes it sound like less, but it's like a small, rather beautiful jewel.
His Phantom of the Opera has been enormously successful. Yours hasn't been. Why is that?
It's been pretty successful. I mean, we've had a 2.5-year tour in North America. Took 18.6 million in the first year, paid its costs back in 6 weeks. That's not bad. Well, now we're in the West End, so I wouldn't say it hasn't been successful. It hasn't been as successful as Andrew's, maybe. But that's a matter of choice.
So, for the first time anyone can remember, there are two musicals with the same name running in London at the same time. So, theatregoers, take note. Andrew Lloyd Webber's Phantom of the Opera is still at Her Majesty's. This one opens at the Shaftesbury on Wednesday. Christopher Rainbow for Thames News.